well, nausea. It's all nothing but a race against the rot growing from the outside in. It's the building pressure behind your ears that keeps on growing until you have to stop and make sure that the world isn't shaking around you. It's waking up tired and dead, drinking coffee and smoking cigarettes, and always being just one cup or one butt away from being alive. But before you get there, you are so nervous and so jittery that you need a beer, and that becomes a three, and it's still not even noon yet. Now the paranoia kicks in, and yes, they are all watching you, all of them. And by three, you're all dried out, your head throbs, your guts burn, but you still force down that whiskey and coke, trying to kill the headache. And you feel like shit because you're drinking yourself out of a hangover, and it's only 5 p.m. Fuck it, you decide. You know you're never going to stop running, and there's so many things to run from, and you know you are only one drink away from breaking the chain. By 10, you can't even stand anymore, and the chemical stew has you on your knees, and someone is cheering, and they call you a champ for getting it all out in one shot. But fuck them, because you know that they aren't going to be kissing you goodnight. Fuck them, because you're the champ, and by 1 in the morning, who the fuck even knows where you are? But there's music and women, and there's oh so many women, and you turn through waves of tight asses and perky tits, and then the only thing you know is that you are only one drink away from making some serious fucking magic with that goddess in the corner with the big hair. Now let me tell you, that hair is fucking huge, and in case you forget, you are going to score, because you are the goddamn fucking champ. But somewhere, somehow, it all clouds up, and the world is lurching beneath you, and you're in a car, and you hope that you're not driving, and you're pretty sure that you're not driving, but you admit you can never really be sure about anything until you are back in your bed, and it is 3 o'clock in the morning, and you are hugging that empty garbage pail up against your face just in case of accident, and you moan, hoping that oblivion comes and takes over. Then you smile, because you have won. You've left it all so far behind that not even God can find you now. You smile because you beat the chase again. And after all, it's all nothing but a slow, comfortable screw against the wall. Anyway.